Hey, what's up? The gray and white fenders that you see here, orange and white, were designed by a genius fellow maker from down under, Peter H. He's part of the V1 engineering community. Part of the genius of Ryan, the founder of V1 engineering, is that he's created not only ingenious machines, but also a community of people literally around the world. And Peter H., this wonderful Aussie genius maker, not only has come up with these fenders and shared them with the community, but he's also accommodated with spacers different thicknesses of YZ plates on the Lowrider V3 do-it-yourself, mostly printed CNC. And that normally would take care of most folks, but there's a subset within the community that have designed their lowriders using extra tall YZ plates, and I'm in that group. And then to compound things and complicate things even more, my YZ plates are thicker than most folks at 19 millimeters. And then to compound things even more on top of that, my lowrider has a modification that I created called the hidden belts modification. So I had to really kind of get creative to be able to remix his design so that I could put these nice fenders on my lowrider. Here you see me using a drilling hole, pre-drilling placement jig that I designed and printed that allows me to put the mount clips in the perfect place on the Y extend plate that is part of my hidden belts mod. And a few moments ago, you saw some screenshots of the 3D design work that I did to come up with a third add-on fender that covers this Y extend plate. I was really thrilled. The pre-drilling hole placement jig works perfectly. It's designed to be bi-directional so that it can accommodate both sides. And it did the trick just wonderfully. And then the mini clips that I designed as a remix off of Peter H.'s larger mount clips also worked great. Because my YZ plate is thicker, Peter graciously designed not only a set of fenders for the taller YZ plates, but he also made a set of modified mounting clips for that set that he graciously designed for me. And those clips were shallower to allow the fender to remain unchanged in its dimensions as far as thickness goes and still accommodate my thicker YZ plate. And so this is me mounting the mini clips that I came up with in order to attach that third fender that I designed. His design included a 3D printed icon button for V1 engineering. And on my add-on third fender, I also included a printed icon for my design8studio.com. And you can see me here using CA glue to attach both of those printed icon button badges to this nice fender setup. And this worked great. Just a really clever design that he came up with, and I just kind of copied it for my own logo. And then, of course, just rinse and repeat to glue in the V1 engineering icon. And that came out wonderfully. Show that off here in a moment. Here was my second test fit install of the new third fender that accommodates the Y extend plate that's part of my hidden belts mod. And a little gratuitous 3D printing footage of the top fender. Okay, so my top fender, I use my cradle as a marking template to mark the holes for mounting my cradle on the new top fender. I used a 5/32 drill bit to pre-drill these, and I've used some tapered head M4x10 screws that I'm going to use to attach this, and some M4 nuts on the other side. Okay, so the way Peter, my famous and genius Aussie creator friend, has indicated that these clips should be positioned properly is to insert the clips into the top only. The bottoms will be sticking out. Position the top on your side assembly and mark and pre-drill for that. Then move the clips over into the bottom assembly only and position it and pre-drill, mark and pre-drill for that. I suppose alternatively, one way would be to do the top mark and pre-drill and then screw them in place. One screw holding each clip, and then try to snap the top off while the clips are still in place, and then put the bottom onto the clips that are halfway screwed, and then mark and drill the top screw locations. So I'm not sure which I'm going to try yet, but I'm going to give that a try. I'm going to tell you, they seat really firmly in position. I mean, really firmly. I can imagine that would be a little bit difficult to get out. That one is so hard to seat that I think I may leave it right where it is. In fact, I'm wishing I hadn't seated that one all the way in. All right, let's head over. I'm going to be pre-drilling in these two holes here and using screws into my MDF to mount those. Okay, I found that trying to get that thing out when it's totally seated in there without any way of getting leverage evenly on it just breaks it. I snapped off several of the clip mounts. I wound up super gluing the broken off portion back on just so I can get pre-drilled location, but I'll have to print another one of the longer clips. I'm starting to wonder if maybe printing these clips out of TPU so I get a little bit of flexibility on them. And the whole thing just came together really well. The only thing I ran into is that both the mini clips and the larger main clips, since they're shallower and they're printed in a way that has the flexing happening in a way that leverages the layer line adhesion weakness of 3D printed parts, that meant that after a couple of test installations and removals, on the mini clips, the fins on them broke. And on the larger main clips, those broke after one test installation followed by a removal. I mentioned these fin clip breakage issues to Peter, and he had a couple of suggestions for possible ways to remedy that. One was to print the clips on a diagonal with a bit of organic support, and this would change the layer line orientation, giving more strength for a more robust flexing ability, which I think is a great idea. Here in a moment, you'll see me trying to install that third fender without yet realizing that the clips were already broken. And as soon as I realized that off camera, I printed some more clips, and here two of three are installed, and I'm installing a third reprinted clip, and that got my third fender attached nice and solidly. As Peter mentions, these don't help the machine work any better, but they do make it look better. And when you cover up the wires in a nice case, it says more professional in its appearance. It also could keep little prying fingers, little curious fingers out of the lead screw, etc. I really love the way they look, and hope you do too. This is Doug with Design 8 Studio, and until the next video, I wish you happy making.